House Speaker McKeeva Bush weighs in on the grassroots efforts to trigger a people-initiated referendum on the cruise port project. He says he believes the petition will prove futile. Meanwhile, CPR Cayman says after 30-plus years in office, Mr. Bush has grown out of touch and is underestimating the referendum effort. Cayman 27's Joe Avery has more.
For almost 6 months, grassroots group CPR Cayman has been collecting signatures with the goal of taking the cruise berthing facility question to the people. Under Section 70 of the Constitution, this would require signatures from at least one quarter of the electorate. As of January 1st, that number is 5,286.
They're not going to get no signatures to do that with. And government can't pay attention to them. We have to do what is right.
Speaker of the House McKeeva Bush says while there have been many plans for cruise berthing facilities throughout the years, now is the time for action.
We have to advance. And we cannot advance by standing still and doing nothing. We are a developing country. We're going to have all the problems that a developing country will have. But we can manage that. And so if they didn't accept anywhere else, Georgetown Harbor is the only place then. We got to go. Cannot stand still.
We see people like McKeeva making statements that they don't think that this will ever see the light of day or it won't get enough numbers. That's really sad because some of his core supporters signed this petition.
Mario Rankin says CPR Cayman has collected well over 4,000 voter signatures with some 40 petition books still in circulation. He says he believes Mr. Bush and other politicians are underestimating public opinion on the referendum.
And all we're asking for them to do is just listen and take that into consideration, because whether they want to be a part of it or listen, the Constitution gives us that right.
The country has to have proper facilities. We just can't say we're a tourist and a top tourist destination. And what do we have? The worst docking facilities?
As Mr. Bush's support for the cruise berthing facility remains unwavering, CPR Cayman hopes to serve the speaker and other naysayers a slice of humble pie.
When we submit, you know, the 5,288 to the election office, I think that would say he'd be singing a very different tune.
Joe Avery, Cayman 27.
Despite CPR Cayman's push to take the cruise port question to the people over financial and economic concerns, Premier Alden McLaughlin recently indicated it's full steam ahead on the project. He says it is crucial to safeguarding Cayman's economic future.